The organic chemistry course would be discussed in four parts, or as we call them as course parts in Study Studio. To enter into any arena, we require some passes, right? So we have four passes to enter into these course parts, and we will pass on into every next course by taking these passes. The initial pass will be given as you enter the course, and every next pass would be provided at the entry of next pass for free, but on one condition. Please take up the next pass only when you have finished traversing through the earlier path completely. I mean, when you have understood the earlier course path completely. You'll grasp well in the next path only when you understand the previous path to the fullest. So, the passes are analysis, nomenclature and isomerism, general organic chemistry, reaction mechanism and organic molecules. So, what are the things you'd be learning in each of these course paths? In analysis, nomenclature and isomerism, we'll first discuss the basics of organic chemistry. These are the most basic concepts of organic compounds that pave a bridge between the class 10 organic chemistry and organic chemistry of the present class. Then we'll be analyzing organic compounds qualitatively and quantitatively. Then we'll jump into the discussion about nomenclature of organic compounds, and then we'll discuss about the isomerism. These topics are very easy to learn and very easy to score marks in JEE and BITSET. Around 1 to 2 questions come from this course which will be easy to score. Most of the students leave these questions because they feel that these questions are just fact-based and not logical. But to score in exams, you should have all types of skills, right? Like how to learn fact-based things in an easy way. And this is also a skill, right, to score marks in an exam. I'll help you to the fullest to make this possible, but you should also try your level best to make this possible, like contributing your hard work toward this thing. I'll be discussing in the later part of this video on how to deal with things like making this thing possible, like making the fact-based things logical and learning them, right? In general organic chemistry, we'll be mostly discussing about reaction intermediates, namely carbocations, carbanions, free radicals, carbenes and nitrines. And we'll also discuss about the stability of the reaction intermediates and their application in strength of acids and bases, resonance and their applications, and aromatic compounds and their applications in stability of reaction intermediates would be the main agenda in this course path. So, general organic chemistry, abbreviated as GOC, is a very weighted topic in organic chemistry. If not directly, the use of these topics and the foundation formed in this course path helps a lot in further topics and questions related to the reactions. So, to understand some of the reaction mechanisms and how they occur, it depends on the stability of reaction intermediates. So, you need to have a good knowledge on how to determine the stability of reaction intermediates. We also face some questions like which of the following reactions is or are feasible, or which of the following substrates undergo a particular reaction, or at what rate reaction undergoes. To answer such questions, a good knowledge of GOC is very much required. Right. In reaction mechanism, we'll be discussing different reaction mechanisms that lead to different named reactions. These reaction mechanisms help a lot in understanding the named reactions and attempting questions in exams. They are classical carbocation reactions, non-classical carbocation reactions, elimination reactions, substitution reactions, and the reactions related to aromatic compounds and reactions related to nitrine reaction intermediate. We'll also discuss the oxidation and reduction reagents, which are very important in the exam point of view. We'll try to finish most of the named reaction in this course path itself. If you are left with some of the named reactions, we'll look into them in the next course path as per the necessity. Then we finish the course with the discussion about organic molecules. We'll be discussing about these organic molecules, and we'll discuss their preparation reactions and conversions from one molecule to another and the means to achieve this. You will see these topics as chapter names in your textbooks, and most of them teach organic in this manner. Like whenever you discuss about a particular molecule, they teach you the reaction mechanism whenever necessary, and they'll discuss the required reagents wherever necessary. But we will be dealing organic in a different way. When you understand the reaction mechanisms completely, then there would be no issues in understanding the named reactions, and it would be easier for you to remember them as well. If you learn these in this format, like in the format of organic molecules, then there's a possibility that you might forget most of the reagents, and when you learn it based on the reaction mechanism, there will be no problem when you solve the advanced level problems as well, because most of them would be based on reaction mechanism and not on the fact-based things. In addition to these four passes to ace organic chemistry, we provide three extra passes. These are called the bonus courses, as we call them, and these courses would also be taken on this channel, and they are biomolecules, polymers, and chemistry in everyday life. When you complete this organic course, we will also be completing or will be ongoing with these bonus courses. And if you wish to join these courses after the organic course, you can always join by viewing the videos available on the channel. So the course which would be taking would be comprised of theory, and then we'll solve some sample questions to understand the theory properly, and then to understand how questions come in exams, and you'll also be knowing the loopholes in the questions and how to tackle them. I'll also provide some assignments meanwhile and discuss its solutions as well in the course part. So this is all about the course plan and how will we be progressing in our organic journey. So before we jumpstart into knowing the guide to organic chemistry, there's an important note for you. You can take up this course at any time of your preparation journey, as this is a self-driven course and do not require any involvement of other topics. I guess there would be the use of equilibrium and kinetics in some cases, but that's fine. We can ponder upon that later during the explanation part, and I'll give you the required details then and there itself. So, spaced repetition of organic chemistry. The thing is, you need to repeat the concepts learned again and again to make them incorporated in your minds and hearts, so that you don't require the need of them to look upon during problem solving sessions. Spaced repetition is like you review the concepts at gradually increasing intervals. To make it easier, it's like you learn something today, then you repeat it after 1 or 2 days, and then take a space of 1 week, and then again review it, and then again take a space of 15 days, and again revise it, and then take a space of 1 month, and then continue the process. In this manner, 80% of the concepts remain incorporated in your minds. If you are not revising the things in this manner, you won't be able to recall information when asked after some time, and your work piles up at the end, which finally leads to the abortion of your JEE journey due to stress. You need to be very proficient with the basic concepts so that you can spend your time on different logical questions. If you are stuck up on the same beginner questions for long, then you won't be having enough time to try new questions, explore new concepts, and learning new strategies in solving questions. So you devote some of your time daily until your course is completed, like around 15 minutes, to revise the concepts learned and be very clear upon those concepts. Practice some elementary problems in meantime. Mail me or PM me if you have any doubts. I'll try to answer your queries. And when you are about to finish the course or have finished the course completely, spend at least 30 minutes daily to revise the concepts and practice them, because organic is all about practice. To practice, you need to be very proficient with the concepts. Because practice makes a man perfect, even in organic chemistry. And to practice, you can use any of the standard books, namely Himanshu Pandey, Advanced Problems in Organic Chemistry for IIT JEE, or MS Chauhan, Elementary and Advanced Problems in Organic Chemistry for JEE. You'll be getting the solution manual for MS Chauhan when you buy the book on any e-commerce website like Amazon or Flipkart. Look up for the manual and get it dispatched. You'll also be getting the solution manual of Himanshu Pandey online. If you are unable to find it, PM me on my Instagram or mail me. I'll try to get it shared for you on Drive. So you get two versions of MS Chauhan in market: the Elementary Problems book and Advanced Problems book. The Elementary Problems comprise of questions which help you to practice a lot of basic and moderately difficult questions, and the Advanced book help you to solve some logical problems which help you in strengthening the concepts to a master level. Even if you solve lesser number of questions from this Advanced book, it makes you a pro, and it means a lot to you because you gain knowledge on solving every question, right? During the course plan, try to complete the elementary problems to a maximum level. Not necessarily everything, but complete as much as you can. And as the course progresses to the finale, then start with the advanced problems. Then you will not only start reviving the older concepts, but also you will gain knowledge on older concepts to a more deeper level. Himanshu Pandey is a sort of mixture kind of book. You will find all kinds of problems, basic and advanced, but most of them are advanced. You will also gain knowledge from this book. GOC in this book is pretty awesome, dude. You need to try it. and like try solving any of the book. Anyway, you don't have enough time to solve both the authors in your JEE journey. Try any one of those, it's fine. You'll not require the use of other topics from chemistry during elementary days of our course. But as the course proceeds and you need to get started with the advanced problems, you will be requiring the use of other topics. By the way, you should have get prepared to solve some inter-concept related problems, like you get problems related to equilibrium and organic chemistry and kinetics and organic chemistry, electrochemistry and organic chemistry, and even thermodynamics and organic chemistry. You need to be prepared to use these interconnected concepts, because when you get to see them in your problems in JEE Advanced, or for matter even in the case of mains, some cases there are interconcept related questions, and you should have practice on those, as you won't feel astonished by looking at them in your exams during the time. You don't need to feel shocked at the time, like I don't know how to use equilibrium in organic chemistry. You need to be well prepared before on how to use interconcept connected questions. I'll try to discuss some questions related to these problems also, because they help you a lot in JEE Advanced. So how to learn these fact-based things easily? The topics in organic, like analysis, purification, biomolecules and polymers, chemistry in everyday life, like this bonus courses are completely fact-based with little logical aspects. So if you don't revise them often, there is a high probability that you forget these chapters. The best way is to revise them regularly so that you will remember most of them. And as you solve questions from these topics, you'll be good in some topics of these units. And there would be some topics which would be very hard to understand logically. No excuses, you should learn them by heart. For purification and analysis, we can think logically how the processes are occurring, and we can come to some legit conclusions, and it would be easier than how to remember that stuff. I'll try my level best to make this possible during the analysis and purification discussion. We can make it logical by discussing why purification is necessary and on what basis the purification is done, and why is it divided into many different types based on the different organic molecules. After purification, there is a requirement for analysis, and why do we analyze the organic compounds and how do we analyze. This can be logically discussed, and I'll try my level best. Biomolecules become easier once you look into the inner concepts and remember the reactions looking up on the structures. The biomolecules might look devil for you when you look it from outside, but biomolecules is such a sweet topic. It is very easy to learn because every reaction is based on its structure, and most of the questions are very easy. I'll try to make biomolecules as easy as I can. Polymers become simpler only after you complete the polymers course and jot it down into complete two sheets, and I'll try to provide those short notes of polymers at the end of the course, which will help you to solve any question coming from the chapter. I'll try to provide short notes for some other important concepts as well if I can, like the reagents and stuff. Try to make your own short notes, because even if you have a short notes from the external source, it's always better that you prepare short notes of yourself. I'll provide a template short note for you, which would be easy for cross-checking between these, and if you missed any points, you can add it down to your short notes. But it's always better that you have your own short notes and you read from your own short notes, right? Chemistry in everyday life is a typical chapter, I agree, so you need to revise it often. I want to add another point related to chemistry in everyday life. There's no much weightage of chemistry in everyday life in JEE Advanced. You need to learn only chemistry in everyday life for one question for JEE Main and one question for bit set. So manage your time accordingly on how you are spending your time towards this chapter. You are not. I think you're matured enough to prioritize between the things, which one is good and which one is not. I'll try providing you some inputs regarding the importance and weightage of these chapters. You need to analyze which one is necessary and how much effort am I putting to that particular unit. Because I feel chemistry in real life can be discussed once, you can revise it taking a space of 1 month time, and then during your mains or bit set 2 days before it, you can just read it half an hour daily to get things in your mind, and that's fine for chemistry in real life. I'll discuss about this chapter during the required session. So guys, good luck for your organic journey. This is what I wanted to say. This is lecture number 0, wherein we discuss the beginner's guide to organic chemistry. The next video most probably would be the basics of organic chemistry, which is lecture number 1. So, bye bye.